Hey guys, it's me, Mr. 250, and welcome back to Tales of Berseria. We defeated the lizard last time, sort of, and with the presentation of the tale, we might just be able to complete this whole thing. I didn't talk to you. Did you find anything in Hadlow Hollow? Well, if you did, remember it's got nothing to do with us. Just so we're clear on that. I didn't figure there'd be my... Well, actually... Yeah, I can probably talk to that girl. You ever hear of a fortune apple? It's supposed to bring good luck. You could sure use one of those. That has absolutely nothing to do with the conversation, but that's alright. You're just a kid after all. I didn't think there'd be a whole lot going on in here. I don't really seem to care dramatically, and it wasn't for them anyway. So it's been a little bit since last time, yet again. Just been really busy lately is all. Yeah, I'm gonna have to go back to the back again. It's been really busy lately, so I've been having trouble getting around to playing more, but we got today off, so we're gonna do some more today. What's the point in going that way? That's the way I went back, I'm fairly certain. It's just like a ever so slight shortcut. It might save you a grand total of like a second. If that even. 7 gold. If it wasn't for the fact that I have to collect everything, because it's like my drug or something, it wouldn't be such a big deal, but everything respawns. So I have to collect everything. I'm also noticing previous Tales games did this where they would, you know, on the minimap they would leave like a line of dots where you've been. This one actually lasts for a while. Like the dots stay on the map for a while, I like that. Seems like a, you know, a small but still fairly decent navigational help. Are those kids at it again? Oh no, no, it's somebody else.
We're lucky the snow has been white for the past few years.
Why is that lucky? Snow is always white.
Wrong. In Helleves, it isn't always.
Is it yellow?
On the direction of the wind and what the volcano is up to. Volcanic
ash can mix
in with the snow and turn it gray.
There's a volcano nearby?
It's actually quite a ways up north, but it's the biggest volcano in all of Midgand. Mount Killaraus, it's called. And that's where we mine our flamestone. Actually, it's the only place you can mine the stuff.
Mount Killaraus.
It's got a nice ring to it. You ever seen a volcano, Velvet?
No, and I'm not interested.
Have a feeling we're gonna be seeing it anyway. Getting snow off the roof is a pain no matter what color it is. I can tell you don't see snow too much. Getting up on the roof is fine, but take care you don't slip and fall once you're up there. That's one thing I've never really had to deal with too much is too much snow, though I've heard people have to actually shovel it off of roofs if there's too much, otherwise it will, like, break your roof. And that would be really bad.
This is Dial's tale. Did you really kill him?
We found him dead in a lake of tar.
Him or some other
this
blizzard guy.
This is all we could bring back.
Is that so?
You can doubt me all you like, but I brought you the demon's body. Who else can say that?
True enough.
Good. Get to work on my ship, then.
I'm afraid we can't. We still need Lady Teresa's permission first.
I'm in a hurry. It would be much worse for you if she knew who the real smugglers were.
You wouldn't!
It's a trade.
I would.
Repair the ship on the beach, and I'll sail away quietly.
Very well. I'll find you your shipwrights. We'll see you at the shore. Hey, Velvet. This would be a perfect opportunity for us to upgrade our equipment. How about it?
What are you talking about?
You don't know?
Boy, lesson time.
We didn't have anything like that in our village.
All the more reason then. Come on, let's go.
Hey, you don't need to be so pushy.
That's just how I am. Get used to it. Come on.
Come on, Velvet, it'll help you murder better. Seem to like that. The Novice Smith's Acerite, you can now enhance and dismantle equipment at the shops. Alright, let's try that. Ah, okay, so all those little bits of everything I've been picking up, I imagine, will be useful for upgrades and such. Okay. Gotcha, so you dismantle to get materials and then enhance to make a single weapon better, I would say. I don't know how often I'll be doing
that's
that.
That's how it's done. Get it?
But it's probably good
I
to know.
I suppose. It seems like kind of a hassle.
That's what I'm feeling.
Yeah, maybe at first, sure. But once you get it down, it'll be second nature. You'll eventually learn how to maximize your personal strengths through wise upgrading and dismantling.
It does seem useful.
Right? If you plan to continue your crusade, upgrading may give you the edge you need. Of course, those who are inadequately prepared for battle probably won't end up on the winning side.
That's certainly true enough. And hey, if it'll make me stronger, I'm sure I'll figure it out. If it'll help me take him down.
It just kind of seems like I might do it if it's not too difficult, but I probably wouldn't like grind for anything. Because most of the time when you get to new areas, they have better equipment to buy anyway. You know? I might not end up selling things. I might be more akin to dismantling things. See, I don't mind doing it if I've already got the materials. I just don't know if I'd go out of my way to enhance things, you know, way beyond what they're at. Though these are cheap, and they didn't require too much stuff, although I just ran out of stuff. So I don't mind doing it a little bit, I guess. So I presume our ship is done now? You're just kind of wasting some time there? Did you hear? Dial's dead! He was a demon, but I still feel sorry for him. Guess that's how the world works. Anyway, we need to inform the Abbey. We have our old lives back, at least. Whoops. Let's hurry up and get out of here. It's for a mutual good, am I wrong? I have a distinct feeling we're going to run into the Praetor before we leave at some point. I don't know, I'm just kind of getting that vibe. Like, right as we leave, they'll be like, "Who's the person that's been working on ships when I said no ship working?" You know, something like that. Or maybe we'll find our ship repairman dead to the hands of some monster.
Well, it looks like we'll get the repairs we need.
Maybe, but that's only half of our problem. Without a proper crew, we'll wind up shipwrecked again.
We don't have time to find one, and we can't hire a ship without permission.
We'll just have to do what we can. But we've seen where my sailing skills get us.
I'm not forcing you to come. I'll do it alone if I have to.
I wonder if there are any free sailors around.
Hello? Any sailors wandering around looking for a ship to go on? No pay? I don't have any money? And I've got some money, but you can't have it. At the very least, these cat souls seem pretty easy to come across. They're pretty common. Especially considering they regenerate. There's not really any negatives, you know, to picking them up. Like, every time you run through a field, you can just pick them up. Do they have quick travel yet? I can't remember if they implemented that. Whatever. I don't think they did. I'm not a massive fan of those normal quick traveling techniques of just point at the map where you want to go, press A, and you go. Feels cheap. I like how some of the RPGs and Tales games have done it in the past, where like you get a boat or an airship or something. And you can just use that to really quickly travel around the world. Much more satisfying than point to destination on map and go there.
Oh, here
we go. That is still very satisfying.
Just wait until I pull out the good stuff.
The fighting system is very satisfying.
Do the demons you kill turn back into humans?
Huh? What are you talking about?
Remember the demon that attacked us near the coast? When it died, it turned back into a human.
That is true.
Every demon I've killed has stayed a demon. So, I was just wondering what was different.
Do demons stay demons when they die? But what about Nico and the villagers I killed?
Maybe it's just a case-by-case sort of thing.
Who cares? A corpse is a corpse, whether it's human or demon.
Yeah. I guess being human again doesn't help much if you're already dead.
Exactly. All that matters is that the demons I devour make me stronger. Nothing more.
I was kind of wondering that too. It seemed to be kind of random. Just every once in a while, when you kill a demon, it turns into a human. I wonder if that makes us a good person or not. I mean, it's not our goal to save them, so that could honestly go either way. Just kind of a happy byproduct, I guess, for the good people.
She's hopeless. Her keel's busted. It'd be faster to build
Dang
a new
it.
Ship.
Her keel?
You could say she's like a man with a broken back.
And how in blazes did you end up running aground here? I wouldn't think it possible.
If you can't help, that's enough. Go back to town.
What now? Do we try to find a new ship?
I can't think of anything else. I just hope we have time.
Make it work. I don't care.
Oh, Empyrean Enominat. Hear my prayer. Blessings and honor unto thee. This frail flesh a sacrifice to be thy foundation.
Sister.
Oh, Oscar! What brings you here? Your face! What happened to you?
I was lit on fire.
The demon got the better of me. I've been summoned back to the Abbey, but I thought I'd stop by on my way.
My poor brother. I'm so sorry.
There is pain, but I can still fight. The scar will serve to remind me of my inexperience.
An underhanded foe, no doubt.
No. The demon saps her enemy's strength with her left hand and turns it against them. It was a girl with black hair and eyes full of fire.
She's also very scantily clad.
She poses a threat for even a seasoned praetor. Please, take care, dear sister.
It was her!
Teresa?
Understood. I will.
Yeah, we're gonna come back to the town and get the crap beat out of us.
A failure as minor as this is not the end of the world.
To be honest, I came hoping you would cheer me up like that. Well, I do believe I recognize those earrings.
Of course. I treasure them dearly. Thank you.
They suit you just as well as I thought they would. I must take my leave now.
Lady Teresa, we've captured a stowaway.
I wasn't stowing away, you twit! I merely boarded without permission!
You! You're a collaborator with that demon woman. Where is she?
Your tortures are useless against the mighty Mogilu! Because I'll spill my guts just fine without him.
Yeah, I kind of saw that coming. We're gonna get back to town, and there's gonna be a blockade, and we're gonna have to probably run through that area that was, I think, that cave that I was looking at that was boarded off. Or not boarded off, but it was guarded. I'm feeling it. I think that's what's gonna be happening. Try to make this quick if we can and avoid all the enemies. Just gotta avoid the bug. The bugs are very fast. I don't know, I really liked that cutscene with the two praetors. Oscar and all. It's just something that felt really fun about it.
There was word from the Abbey. They're holding a public execution for a witch who tried to draw demons into the city.
Is that so? Sounds like a real nasty character.
I'd stay away from the city if I were you. It's a common tactic for Lady Teresa. Threaten one criminal to draw out their allies.
Are you saying I'm a criminal? Pot calling the kettle black, isn't it?
That's why I'm warning you. Lady Teresa's top class, even among exorcist praetors. I wouldn't think badly of you if you fled.
A witch. It has to be Mogilu, huh?
It looks like the Abbey is onto us. We'd best assume they've already found the tunnel.
No sense trying to buy a ship now.
Then don't buy one. Steal it.
Steal a ship from Helavise. Just the two of us.
We have at least one other on our side.
Dial?
He said he can navigate. If he joins forces with us, all the better.
That could be. But what happens to Mogilu?
I suppose that's up to the Abbey.
Don't care. Not really.
Let's head to Dial's cave.
Aw, man.
Sorry, Mogilu. Rest in peace.
This is gonna get a little tedious, all this backtracking. That's alright. Maybe he's at the entrance. Maybe this won't be hard. Oh, bug. They don't turn too well, but they are very fast. Please don't make me run all the way to the back of the cave. It's got tedious really quickly. I have a distinct feeling they're going to make me run all the way to the back of the cave. Although, wait, is that a teleporter? Yes, that will teleport us deeper into the cave. This is very good. Very good. Not nearly as tedious. Thank you for the warp. You ready to begin your assault?
What are you two doing back here?
Things didn't work out. We'll lend a hand with your raid.
Awfully presumptuous, aren't you?
I'm a demon. Comes with the territory.
You got me there. Ah, gods. I think that's the first time I've laughed since turning demon. But are you sure? It's suicide, you know.
Maybe not. I have a plan. The exorcists have a hostage they're using to lure me into the city.
Then we can sneak in through the tunnel into the storehouse.
No. I expect they'll have an ambush ready there. So instead, we hit them with a direct frontal assault.
You call that a plan?
No. I call it a feint. As their forces converge on the front, a second group slips in via the tunnel, strikes the docks, and secures a ship. After that, the two groups meet up and we all sail away. And I want you at the helm.
Answer me this, then. Who's making this frontal assault of yours?
I will, naturally.
That works. When?
Tomorrow. Can we rest here until then?
Make yourself at home. Nothing so comfy as a bed of tar.
Ha ha ha.
Velvet? Hey, Velvet?
Luffy?
Luffy, get out of my dreams. I'm trying to do bad things.
Were you having a nightmare? I was... Oh, Luffy, it was terrible! Hey, come on, let go of me. I have to go. I have something important to do.
What's that?
Arthur told me to come meet him at the Shrine of Tranquility.
And don't listen to him, he's bad man.
No, Luffy said! No! Listen to me! Artorias is... He's going to...
Are you all right? You were tossing and turning.
Sorry, my rock pillow and tar blanket weren't very comfortable.
If you don't want to go with me, I understand.
That wouldn't do. How can I repay you if you die?
You are an odd one.
Am I? I always thought of me as just me. Velvet. Who's this Artorias?
My target. He killed my brother.
We're ready. Dial should be at the entrance.
Let's get going then.
Alright, lizard man. Let's go. Is there more plants? No, but there's that. I'm sure there's lots of things I'm missing. Since they always respawn every time you leave and enter an area, it really isn't prudent of me to chase down everything unless it, you know, is pretty much on the way. Although these things are really shiny and it's kind of hard to not chase after them.
Sleep well?
Just fine, thanks. And your special concoction?
Ready for deployment anytime. By the way, I never caught your name.
Velvet.
We'll sail together if you live, Velvet. If not, at least I know what to put on your tombstone.
You've got a sharp tongue.
I've always been that way.
Right then, we're off to attack Helavies.
Alright, is he gonna be in my party? No, he's not. He's just gonna be, you know, cutscene character.
That reminds me. Where do you think that boy who took the compass ran off to?
Helavies, I'd imagine. Since Malakim are always tethered to exorcists.
That means we might run into him during our attack.
Are you getting squeamish about killing the boy because you feel indebted to him for healing you?
No. If he gets in the way, I'll take him down. But...
But?
I have to remember to thank him first.
Right.
Does that bother you at all?
No, not really. I just know that Malakim don't taste very good.
Malakim don't suit your palate? I'll call that a positive.
I think she might choke, though, whenever she sees him again. Laffy set, you know, then fails to guard herself and dies or something. Not a very good plan. Oh gosh, are those two praetors? Are those the guards?
You'll be ah, dang it! My
stupid bug. So good.
I can't even call that a fight.
Suck it, bugs. No, this is just regular dudes. This will be easy.
Who goes there?
Oh, I'm pretty sure you were expecting me.
Yeah, this will be easy.
They were nothing.
Like, nothing. Absolutely nothing. It almost seems like a trap, doesn't it?
The townspeople are gone.
Yep.
I was right. It's a trap.
Yep. That's alright. Let's go rob their stores. Ah, come on. You can rob the stores. We're bad people already. Don't stop for anything. Go, go, go. I see a praetor. Yep, and this is gonna be fun.
Well, look who actually showed up to rescue me. Oh, you're more of a softie than I ever gave you credit for, demon lady.
You're here. You're the demon that escaped the island?
What if I am?
You hurt my dear Oscar. You will pay for that. Slowly.
The Holy Order only punishes its victims slowly.
Come and face me then, exorcist!
I am honor bound to aid her.
Beware her left arm! Set down!
Say I'm down!
Pair of demons should be simple for you.
It's going majorly easy. Sounds so angry.
Who wants to taste my blade next?
You fiends! All exorcists, form up!
This is
going majorly easy. We hear about these exorcists being bad news, and we're just...
Hang in there, Velvet!
...destroying these people. She sounds so mad. Murdered by the thousands.
I admire your endurance. But you will regret this soon enough.
How many exorcists do you have?
Number two.
Uh-oh. No, not Lafayette. My one weakness.
You can't finish your own work. Coward.
I won't fall for your taunts. That arm of yours is too dangerous. Besides... To dispose of demon filth, one ought to use an appropriate tool.
Well, I've got tools of my own. Tools of flamestone, sulfur, and oil.
Those will explode.
That's correct. Yep.
What?
Warehouse going down.
Flamestone.
Shouldn't have kept them all in one warehouse. Then had a backdoor exit to it.
I'm with you.
That was just far too easy for that to happen.
Aren't you forgetting someone?
What are you all doing? After them!
Lady Teresa!
Sorry, ma'am, we're all dead.
The port!
It's all on fire!
Orderlies, put out the fires at once!